We are living during a baffling time, a time that most of us can't quite wrap our heads around, a global epidemic, a crisis that is keeping us indoors and socially distancing ourselves from others. I miss people. I never thought I'd say that. It's a terrifying time, but did you know that some movies predicted even bleaker futures than the one we're currently living in? So today on Top 5 Scary Videos, I'm going to be counting down our list of the top 5 scary dystopian futures in horror movies. Now, there may be a few movies that border the lines of horror, but it's my list, and I can do what I want. Horror is subjective, and if it evokes fear, then it belongs on my list. Before we begin though, be sure to stick around until the end of the video where I'll be responding to some of your comments. And with that, let's jump in. Coming in at number 5, Escape from New York. Escape from New York is a 1981 science fiction horror movie co-written, co-scored, and directed by John Carpenter. The film storyline, set in the near future world of 1997, concerns a crime-ridden United States, which has converted Manhattan Island in New York City into the country's maximum security prison. Air Force One is hijacked by terrorists and is purposefully crashed in New York City. Ex-soldier and current federal prisoner Snake Plissken is given just 24 hours to go in and rescue the President of the United States, after which, if successful, he'll be pardoned. Carpenter wrote the film in the mid-1970s in reaction to the Watergate scandal. Carpenter's view of the future is a decidedly cynical one, and we should be counting our blessings that it is not the timeline we're living in. Escape from New York received hugely positive reviews, with it receiving an 85% on Rotten Tomatoes, with the general consensus reading, "Featuring an atmospherically grimy, futuristic metropolis, Escape from New York is a strange, entertaining jumble of thrilling action and oddball weirdness." Honestly, I highly recommend. Coming in at number 4, we have District 9. District 9 is a 2009 science fiction horror film directed by Neil Blomkamp, written by Blomkamp and Terry Tatchell, and produced by Peter Jackson himself. The film is partially presented in a found footage format by featuring fictional interviews, news footage, and video from surveillance cameras. The story, which explores themes of humanity, xenophobia, and social segregation, begins in an alternate 1982, when an alien spaceship appears over Johannesburg, South Africa. When a population of sick and malnourished insectoid aliens are found aboard on the ship, the South African government confines them to an internment camp called District 9. Years later, during the government's relocation of the aliens to another camp, one of the confined aliens, named Christopher Johnson, tries to escape with his son and return home, crossing paths with the bureaucrat named Wickes van der Meer. District 9 is a genre mashup, taking cues from movies such as Independence Day, The Fly, and RoboCop, with the movie treading familiar territory in an unfamiliar place. It's a rare breed that manages to splice documentary style with stomach-churning body horror. By the end, an action spectacle. Coming in at number 3, we have Battle Royale. Battle Royale is a 2000s Japanese dystopian thriller slash horror movie directed by Kenji Fukasaku, based on the 1999 novel by Koshin Takami. The film follows a group of junior high school students that are forced to fight to the death by the Japanese totalitarian government. The film drew controversy and was banned or excluded from distribution in several countries. Battle Royale became a cultural phenomenon and has been highly influential in global culture. Since the film's release, the term Battle Royale has been redefined to refer to a fictional narrative genre and/or mode of entertainment inspired by the film, where a select group of people are instructed to kill each other off until there is a triumphant survivor. Many can draw comparisons between Battle Royale and The Hunger Games, of course, and that's okay. However, what The Hunger Games tried to do over 3 films, Battle Royale did in just 1. And with far more levity. The movie was a huge hit among critics, with it receiving an 87% on Rotten Tomatoes, with the general consensus reading, "Battle Royale is a controversial and violent parable of adolescence, heightening teenage melodrama with life or death stakes." Coming in at number 2, we have The Purge Anarchy. The Purge Anarchy is a 2014 horror film written and directed by James DeMonaco, a sequel to 2013's The Purge and the second installment in the Purge franchise. While the first film was set entirely in one house, Anarchy takes place around the greater Los Angeles area and shows more of what happens to the surroundings during The Purge. Now, some backstory. The Purge franchise is set in a dystopian United States ruled by a totalitarian government known as the New Founding Fathers during the year 2023. So, 3 years from now, this could be our future. The annual purge, a 12-hour event that legalizes all crimes without authorities intervening, is credited as an economic success. While everyone across the US prepares for the carnage, the nation's impoverished population is no longer seen as people, but as living garbage, whom the wealthy denounce as only living to serve their needs. AKA to kill on the night of Purge. The film currently holds a 56% on Rotten Tomatoes, with the general consensus reading, "Gritty, grisly, and uncommonly ambitious, The Purge Anarchy represents a slight improvement over its predecessor, but still never as smart or resonant as it tries to be. However, I believe Anarchy to be incredibly effective at depicting a lawless night of madness where neighbors turn on neighbor and all rules are thrown out the window. Trust no one, not even your own family, and certainly don't go outside unless you want to be chased down by an angry mob in masks wielding homemade weapons of destruction." Thankfully for us though, we can't go outside, can we? Self-isolation for the win. We all survived Purge this year. And finally, coming in our number one spot, we have Children of Men. Children of Men is a 2006 dystopian thriller slash horror directed and co-written by Alfonso Cuarón. The film takes place in the year 2027. These dates are starting to sound a whole lot closer than they did before, am I right? When 2 decades of human infertility have left society on the brink of collapse. Illegal immigrants seek sanctuary in the United Kingdom, where the last functioning government imposes oppressive immigration laws on refugees. Clive Owen plays civil servant Theo Farron, who must help a refugee escape the chaos. She also is pregnant. Hush hush. The movie from start to finish delivers a sense of dread, the sense of relentless, inevitable doom. Clive Owen's character wanders amongst the increasingly civil unrest fueled by British armed forces clamping down on refugees fleeing the rest of the world. His odyssey takes him through the last vestiges of a broken world in a war-torn urban battlefield. It is an absolutely terrifying future to fathom. Children of Men received hugely critical acclaim. On Rotten Tomatoes, the film received a 92% approval rating, with the general consensus reading, "Children of Men works on every level as a violent chase thriller, a fantastical cautionary tale, and a sophisticated human drama about society struggling to live. Children of Men is the most immersive apocalyptic movie we have ever experienced on screen, and arguably the most frightening. A world without children, can we imagine?" Well, there we have it. Do you guys agree with our list? Were there any dystopian futures that we missed? Leave us all your thoughts and feelings in the comments down below, and perhaps we can do a part 2. Before I go though, I just want to respond to a few comments from one of our last videos. Top 5 Scariest Lovecraftian Gods from Cosmic Horror. Billy Turner said, "Thanks for taking the time to set up a studio in the house for us, Lucy. Keep safe, Dark Queen." Well, not a problem at all. Thank you for tuning in and watching. The setup's in my bedroom, so really what I do is I wake up, I walk 2 feet, and then I sit in my chair, and then I film these videos for you. Honestly, I can't complain. Ancestor Empire said, "Loving the at-home sound, it gives more into the doomed atmosphere of Lovecraft. I don't know what it is about recording at home. I feel my voice is deeper now, and I feel more serious. Maybe it's because the world is serious and everything's sad." James Vance said, "Lovecraft had some serious issues. I mean, who else can come up with the things he does? He's a genius." But also, he probably had a few issues. But a genius. Pierre Renaud Crutalis, I think that's how you say it, said, "Which Lovecraft book was it?" It was actually his entire collection. Not the Necronomicon, if only, but an entire collection. Cameron Hersey said, "Instead of Tinkerbell, how about a vicious vixen pixie?" Sure, why not? Or why don't we just stick with the Dark Queen? And on that note, if you haven't already, be sure to give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you never miss another scary vid. And until next time, see you later.